Hello and welcome back to my Oldtown series. We are playing as the Hightowers and we want to make the Oldtown Kingdom. Whatever I call it. I'll think of a name when we get there, but first I need another duchy. I'm fabricating claims on this, but stuff doesn't want to come through now, does it? In the arbiter to fabricate claims, he's quite good at his job. My brother here, Humphrey. Just needs to get on with it a bit better. May his reign be blessed. I don't really care. Sir Humphrey, personal interaction. Let's send him some cash, see if that makes him a bit happier. Personal, send a gift. That'll make him like me more. I don't know if it'll make him work faster, but it's worth a try. Excuse me, whilst I just have a quick drink here. So yes, a recap. Last episode, my initial ruler was depressed, so I killed myself. And then Lord Mace put me in charge of an army, and I ended up becoming incapable. So Bright Smile is currently useless. I've married both of my brothers off to strong northern women. So we should hopefully get some strong children come through, get the genes in. Try the eugenics program, getting strong involved. The war against the north is nearly won. So that's good. What I think would make this game more interactive as a vassal is if you were given the main charge. If you were actually commanding the troops and not the AI. Like, the king would, of course, have rule over his main garrison, but in a ward, you don't have just have one stack. You have all the armies moving about. So yes, I think if that was implemented in the game, that would be awesome. Something like that. The more battles I win, the better I do, the more prestige we get. So who are we at war with now? Stannis. We're at war with Stannis. And the war's nearly over. So what does that do? Stick King's Justin Bieber on the throne. And I can't plot to kill him because I'm incapable. Lovely. Somebody please kill my character. So yes, my aim is to gain power through vassal land and such. Move through this land, take more land, just consume the reach. And just be my own separate identity. Son was born to Sir Humphrey. He's a bastard though. Of Mormont. Yes, she had a bastard child. Oh, that's a shame. I would appreciate it if my brothers made some children, since you are an attractive Layla Hightower and cups. Right, so you're cups. You're an attractive cups. At least we need to get some guys through. Breed some courtiers and such. Where's Euron? Euron, help me out here. I need some chaos. So Stannis has been made Lord Paramount. They'll probably take the land off him and give it to somebody else. I'm not entirely sure. Until next time. And I'm dead. Finally. Excellent. So they did take the north off of Robb Stark here. But yes, I am now Garth Greysteel. I'm married to Lady Liddle here. Alice Liddle. She's lustful. She's not giving me children, however. I would like to have a son that is still gone for. So I have another brother. Married to a Fossaway. Well, I didn't know about you. So, I need a new Master at Arms. I have a Tyrell. Why is there a Tyrell in my court? You could come in handy if I keep breeding Tyrells. Anyway, nope, did not mean to click on that. I need new Master at Arms, and it's going to be you, Tyrell. Could you please train the troops here? Yeah. Very good. I'm going to resend you to do that. And I'm going to send you a bit of money. I'm going to make you the designated regent. And I'm gonna send you some money. Make you like me. So, second episode, third ruler. We're running out of Hightowers here. Send you some money, however. No, no, sir. Good. So the Hightower dynasty is dwindling, it appears. Down to 9. Olivia Hugh. So who can I arrest? I can arrest someone. I can arrest you. Do I want to? Mulmore. Well, I could do. Do my vassals like me? A bit. So yes, I'll try and arrest you. And I got him anyway. Okay, can I revoke your title? No, can I? I can exile him for tyranny, but I don't really want that. I mean, it is some land with some men in it. Tyranny, I'll get, what, 10 tyranny? That'd be negative 10 effects. That would go off to my heir. It won't last that long, but then I don't have the realm size currently, so we'll just avoid that. For now. See, all this land is now back under the reach. Obligate the vassal, sure. Storm's End is at... Shireen. Shireen is Lord Paramount of the Stormlands. Well, isn't that good? The Neck. So you're now part of the Neck. Why are you underneath Lord Howland? Right, don't understand that. Wait, what was that? I thought I saw something. Never mind. He's got Jojen leading troops. Why? Of all the things to do, why would you do that? I do, however, have a bit more money now, that's good. Still, not much is happening. But at least we're not crashing, how about that? Oh no, we don't want to crash. I can call him forward for judgment. See what happens there. I could ransom him. I couldn't. We'll press this button anyway, sometimes it forces them. Host a feast. I'll actually establish a household guard. Great. I will then command them to improve. Train the peasants or levy size. Run out of armies. Control the soldiers. We'll do that. We'll get some better guys instead of faster replenishing. So the realm is at war with Chittering Brook, Hornvale and Rills. And I still don't have a claim on the harbour here. We don't want high authority. We want low authority. In fact, I want to start a faction. Liege Loyalists. He has quite a few Liege Loyalists. A job well done. Good. I want to start a faction for... seniority succession. Gravelkind, Lord Garth. I don't want any of that. I want lower crown authority. So do I actually have ships? Hardly any. A son, so you're a Hightower. Son of my heir, so you will eventually inherit. Unfortunately, you do not have the strong trait. Lord Dickon moves boldly. Lord Dickon of Wal- Randall Tardy is dead. Dickon, however, is not. Right, so Dickon is now an enemy of the realm. Clap the leader in irons. Wait, am I leading troops? I am. There we go. I'll imprison that guy. He wants to have trial by combat. I want to ransom him, preferably. So I hopefully get money, but then we'll do this anyway. He's skilled at arms. He's a cups. He's an old Hightower, won't we do it? We'll do you. We'll let him fight for him. Fight well, Sir Eustace. And you died. So he should walk free. And he's not going to pay me anymore. Well, that's a shame. I thought I might be able to glitch the system there, get the money, whilst having a bit of fun. But sadly, my man died. Right, can I plot to kill Joffrey? I can. Let's do it. Let's kill Joffrey. I do, however, have you as well. Can I, 10 gold, go for it. Alright, so there are wars going on around here. No, whilst that's empty, I'll really love a claim on it. I refuse to use console commands. I want a claim. So, what's your war here? Defending against in their war for Brightwater. Okay, so you all want Brightwater. I don't want you to have Brightwater. Do I have a claim on it? Claim Brightwater in Sir Humphrey's name. He is my brother. I have nothing to give to you. So I don't get a claim, but he does. Well, he's my brother. I may as well get him in charge, if anybody. It's worth a try. I'm, however, now hostile to everybody. But, oh well. Raise up all the men. Get all the men over here. Hopefully nothing bad will happen. So why the Fossaways attacking? They're helping West March. So I'm probably not going to get a chance here. Well, it's worthwhile to call the banners, exercise, manoeuvring my men. How does he have 18,000? He must have a lot of friends. Lord Dickon. I'm, however, hostile to him. Does that mean I can siege his capital? Let's go have a look. I'd rather not border the province they're in. I wonder if I can do that. That'd be quite fun if I can before they win the war. Stay hostile to Dickon and capture him or something to ransom back. Right, looks like the Fossaways have left. So, who am I at war with now? I'm now at war with Dickon. Okay, so let's destroy his army whilst we can. Destroy his army whilst we can. We'll get this land off him. Samwell Tarly's brother, in case you did not know. That is who Dickon is. So hopefully we'll destroy his army here before he calls in some allies. Lord Garth has been injured. Oh, that's a shame. We are a Hightower, we will lead our troops, whether you like it or not. And we captured this guy. Well, that's good. We're now going to Dunbridge. We'll go there, then we'll go over to your capital. We have plenty of wars going on, don't we? But yeah, getting my brother in charge of that land would be nice. It's just they're all underneath him. So am I fighting for this to become my vassal? Putting my so because he's my brother, we force demands, abdicates to Humphrey Hightower. It says he abdicates, but it doesn't say specifically this one title. Where's he going? He's going here, so we'll try and kill off Dickon's army. That might get us to 100%, I'm not sure. It does indeed. Dickon has been defeated. That's what you get for being the son of a great man. For peace, enforce demands. So Lord Dickon of Westmarch abdicates to Humphrey Hightower. Does that mean my man, Humphrey, gets the whole of his titles if he's abdicating to him? Well, let's find out. Humphrey Hightower. What a joke that was. And my brother Humphrey now has all that land. So I want to become Humphrey. Humphrey, become my heir now. Where is Humphrey in line? So I have one brother, the brother's son. Then we become him and we inherit all of that land as well. In fact, his heir is me, so if I plot to kill him... Yes. She's pregnant. Plot to kill him, now. Sinful faceless man, I need intrigue 12. Okay. Well, this is going better than expected. Can I declare... I can claim West March in the name of my brother. Who is my heir. So I can declare on him whilst he has no troops to take that. Okay, well, we're going to do that then. We're going to claim it in the name of my heir. Would cost 50 prestige. Oh, well. Boom. So thank you for watching this second episode. In the next episode, I'll be trying to get my heir brother, instead of killing this guy, to get Westmarch, and then I'll have two duchies, maybe even a third. So I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.